Greetings. When I was growing up, liberalism had really gotten into full swing in the school system of America. One lesson in particular was the lesson of the lifeboat. The purpose of the lesson was values clarification. Maybe you are old enough to remember the example, but I'll briefly describe it. You can probably still find it if you Google lifeboat values clarification exercise. Basically, you are on a ship that sinks and have one lifeboat that can hold 10 people, while 15 people survived the shipwreck. You must decide who lives and who dies. You must argue whether you keep the teacher or the convict. You, as a school child, are faced with people killed because of your decision. It can be rather traumatic, and it is intentionally destructive to the moral fabric of the children. The fundamental psychological purpose of this child abuse was and is to convince children that not all people have the same value. Adjunct with that goal is to attack the Judeo-Christian worldview, which holds all people have value because we are created by God and in God's image. This is the unstated purpose because leftist, progressive, statist, globalist, communist, anti-Christians never honestly admit what they are doing. You have to understand why so many names. Each incarnation, once proven evil, changes names to hide. Well, many actions, oh so many actions, have unintended and unanticipated consequences. The lifeboat conditioning was not free from just such an oversight. Consider the recent American election of one Donald J. Trump as president. Americans are being called racists and bigots and homophobes and anti-immigrant and anti-Muslim. But the Americans are not racists or bigots or homophobes or anti-immigrant. Americans who voted for Donald Trump are good, decent, honest, hard-working individuals. In fact, they were just voting according to their lifeboat training. Decent, law-abiding Americans voted for the lifeboat. The Americans who voted for Donald Trump voted just the way they were conditioned by liberal teachers. Americans voted that illegal immigrants do not have the right to sneak into America, to sneak into the lifeboat. What about ISIS fighters? Do they have a right into the lifeboat? No. Muslims who want to destroy democracy and the lifeboat have no right to be allowed in. Sharia law is the goal of the Islamic invasion, and Americans with clear vision voted to stop the invasion. Americans voted to protect the lifeboat. Americans listened to the lifeboat indoctrination the liberals forced into the schools. And now the liberals, with their agenda, have been smacked in the face by an unintended consequence. The behavior liberals conditioned children to adopt is now being called racist and xenophobic and nationalistic and many other pejorative names. All because the Americans, already in the lifeboat, see their lifeboat being intentionally swamped. Please think about this carefully and slowly. The lesson of the lifeboat drill is that not all people are equal. Only one philosophy, only one worldview, ascribes intrinsic value to every single man, woman, and child on earth. The Judeo-Christian worldview that follows Yahweh, God of heaven and earth. The American lifeboat was founded on this worldview. But unrighteous, godless people have conspired to destroy belief in God. America's founders believed God, our Creator, endowed us with inalienable rights. But once God is excluded from the conversation, there is no intellectually defensible source of this rights thing. The lifeboat is not a Christian doctrine, nor is it a Christian position. However, it is fascinating to watch people so blinded by their arrogance, constantly surprised by the unintended consequences of their half-baked agenda. There is one true God, Yahweh, and all the heathens in the world raging against God cannot stop God's plan in the earth. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.